Hello, Bees Bladers. Welcome back. Welcome, newcomers, to the channel. Holy frickin' moly. Some of you may have seen this, but I'm going to show it to you anyway. This, oh my gosh, are you ready? Is the biggest Axis style anything I've ever seen in my life. It's the Katsu Hatchet Axe, the F801. My gosh, it looks like something from the future. Oh my goodness, holy freaking moly. Do you know what it is? Have you seen this already? I mean, you know, can you guess what it is? Can you tell? Just in case you have it, I'm gonna go from one end to the other so you can get a good look at it. It is black titanium coated, and look at the hardware. This thing is not messing around. This has some serious weight to it. I mean, it's not the heaviest thing in the world, but you can imagine just from its girth, just what you're working with. Oh, and look at this. Here's your axis lock. And oh my gosh, back here you have a glass breaker and a pin for when you open this bad boy. Look at that. Oh my. It's an axe and a splitter. You can split wood or cut some wood with it. Now, I would say if you like to do some outdoor, some bushcrafting or some camping and want to do it in a modern way with some D2 tool steel, and oh yeah, that blade is sharp. Holy moly. Let's take a look here. There you go. There's your blade. There's your design. It is D2 tool steel. And you know, I gotta say, it really fits the hand very well. I would say this would be, if you either want something very cool and you're a collector, or you actually want to use this to do some splitting, you can take this dude out, this pin down here at the bottom. Check this out. Unscrew this, and you can put it inside right there. Oh, by the way, it has a T6 on it, so if you want, you can take this carbon fiber off, probably to clean it out if you get it nice and dirty. So, and this would clean up very well. You put that dude in there, and then you have a pin, so you're not gonna have to worry about any failure. So on top of the crossbar lock, then you're gonna have this pin. Now, if I take this pin out, check this out, look at that. Huge stop pin right there, and look at that. There's where your lockup is, and here's a look at the lock. Oh my gosh. This thing, and it is solid. There is no wiggle woggle, no wibble wabble at all. So I just noticed there, you could actually put a string or a little tiny lanyard on that to screw it into the back here for when you, you're not traveling. You can put the pin in here while you're traveling, so it can't possibly come open in any way, shape, or form, but you can have it down here. You can also use it as a glass breaker. Now, the question is, can I deploy this with one hand? Maybe that is part of the deal, is have it hanging on the front or the back of your pack, somewhere where you can reach it, and then can I open it with one hand? Yes! Oh my gosh. So, the axis is not difficult. It has a pretty strong string to it. Pretty strong spring. But it does work pretty well. I can do it one-handed. I can throw it around. I wonder if you could toss this into a log. That would be my question. But all joking aside, this thing feels like it is seriously meant for business. It has some heft to it. There is nothing chintzy, nothing cheap about this whatsoever. And the last time I looked, this was a couple days ago, these were $35 off on Amazon. These are not cheap. They are not a cheap price. They are not a budget axe or a budget splitter. I bet this would be good. You could actually hold this up here to make you some little kindling wood. And for doing some splitting, you could get another log and hit the back of this. This is, I mean, look how thick this is. This is not joking around. Like, I mean, I just want to laugh because this thing is just so crazy. But as far as really functioning and the form and function, this thing is, I mean, it is meant for business. It is meant to be used. And that is some heavy duty. Heavy, I said duty. Look how thick that steel is. You could use this to do some splitting. And I am curious, you know, I'm not a bushcrafter. I'm not out all in the woods all the time. I wish I could be, but I don't and I can't. But if you're someone that this is up your alley, I'm curious, what do you think about this? Do you think this is practical? Do you think it's impractical? Do you think, I mean, it feels seriously overbuilt. And, you know, it does take up a little less room than having an axe or a small hatchet. I don't know if you would call this a hatchet or a splitter. It's kind of somewhere in between one or the other. but it is very sturdy, and this blade is pretty sharp. Let me check. Will it cut paper? Look at that. Look at that. Oh, my gosh. Okay, it has an edge. Not the sharpest edge in the world, but it does cut paper. Holy moly. So it is meant for business. But these are available. I will have a link in the description where you can go check them out. It is something of curiosity, something that is very neat. It is definitely a conversation starter. But besides all that, I want to know, if you're a backpacker or you go out in the woods or you ever use an axe, I mean, this might be something that if just for your backyard, for starting, we have fires all the time in our backyard. We have a fire pit. This would actually work. I know this would work for me for doing some splitting. You know, I'll split them up into small slivers to start the fire and things like that. I think it would be nice for that kind of, maybe you could call it the urban woodsman axe. But these are from Katsu, and it's a Nemoto Knives design. I think it does look very, very cool. But I want to hear your comments one way or another. Tell me what you think about it. Do you like it? I can't wait for the comments to roll. Good, bad, or indifferent. Let me know what you think about it. And like I said, you can actually lock this down so it can't open up while you're backpacking the Himalayas. I don't know. It does have some heft to it, though. But I hope y'all enjoyed checking this out, and I'll definitely see you in the chats and in the comments and at the Hive stream on Friday nights. Go watch this video. You're going to enjoy those knives. And until I see you again, remember, live life in the present, keep a Band-Aid handy, and don't cut yourself.